All right, let's hear it.
You're all still here for a reason. 80% of this floor was just sent home forever. We spent the last hour saying our goodbyes. They were good people and they were good at their jobs, but you were better. Now they're gone. They're not to be thought of again. This is your opportunity. On every floor of this building and in every office from Hong Kong to London, same thing's happening. By the time we're done, 3 of every 7 guys who were standing between you and your boss's job are gone. That is your opportunity.
Have I ever told you how much I love your bag? Well, really, do you have a little dress that matches it?
Yeah, I do.
Because you could dance around in it like a fucking girl. Hey! Look who's burning the candle at both ends. Why didn't you come out with us? There's no more cuts planned. You don't have to kiss my ass. I frankly don't even know what it is you guys do.
Well, I'm really sorry I had to bring you guys back here, but...
That's all right.
What's going on? Look at this. Eric gave me this file before he left.
Eric?
Dale, and he told me that he couldn't quite figure it out, and the last thing he said to me before the elevator doors closed was be careful.
He said be careful?
Yeah, so obviously I'm a little curious. I start to get into it a little bit, and I realize that the only thing that he's missing, it's just not good, Will.
Okay, so what is he doing here?
No, go to Model 4, it makes more sense.
Okay, all right.
What is this?
This is basically everything that we have in our books at any given time. But what Eric is trying to do is to work these numbers for levels of volatility that fall outside of the standard VAR number.
What are those levels?
Fairly complicated.
Simplify.
The volatility levels are set using historic patterns, basically, and then stretching those patterns out on a 10, 15% run.
All right, so?
So we are starting to test those historic patterns.
When?
Today.
Tuesday.
Monday, last Friday and Wednesday.
Two Fridays ago.
All right, I get it.
Fuck me, once this thing gets going in the wrong direction, this is fucking huge.
How huge?
Well, the losses are greater than the current value of the company.
Projected losses, the projected losses, Will.
This is just our floor?
Yes.
So, why doesn't somebody tell me what they think is going on?
Mr. Tulda, as I mentioned earlier, if you compare the figure at the top of page 13...
Jared, it's a little early for all that. Just speak to me in plain English.
Okay.
But I'd like to speak to the guy who put this together. Mr. Sullivan, is it? Does he speak English?
Sir?
I'd like to speak with the analyst who seems to have stumbled across this mess.
Certainly. That would be Peter Sullivan, right here.
Oh, Mr. Sullivan, you're here. Good morning. Maybe you could tell me what you think is going on here. And please, speak as you might to a young child or a golden retriever. It wasn't brains that got me here, I can assure you of that.
Okay, well, as you probably know, over the last 36 to 40 months, the firm has begun packaging new MBS products that combine several different tranches of rating classification in one tradable security. This has been enormously profitable, as I imagine you noticed.
I have.
Well, the firm is currently doing a considerable amount of this business every day. Now, the problem, which is, I guess, why we are here tonight, is that it takes us, the firm, about a month to layer these products correctly, thereby posing a challenge from a risk management standpoint.
And Mr. Sullivan, that challenge is?
Well, we have to hold these assets on our books longer than we might ideally like to.
Yes.
But the key factor here is these are essentially just mortgages, so that has allowed us to push the leverage considerably beyond what you might be willing or allowed to do in any other circumstance, thereby pushing the risk profile without raising any red flags.
And Mr. Sullivan, what does your model say that that means for us here?
Well, that's where it becomes a projection. But,
You're speaking with me, Mr. Sullivan.
Well, sir, if those assets decrease by just 25% and remain on our books, that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.
So, what you're telling me is that music is about to stop, and we're going to be left holding the biggest bag of odorous excrement ever assembled in the history of capitalism. What have I told you since the first day you stepped into my office? There are three ways to make a living in this business. Be first, be smarter, or cheat. No, I don't cheat. And although I like to think we have some pretty smart people in this building, it sure is a hell of a lot easier to just be first.
Sell it all today.
Is that even possible, Sam?
Yes, but at what cost?
I'll have to pay.
Really?
I think so. Where is this going to come back to us?
Everywhere.
Sam, I don't think you seem to understand what your boy here has just said. If I made you, how would you do this?
Well, you call the traders in for the normal 6:30 meeting and you be honest with them, because they're gonna know it's the end either way. So you're gonna have to throw them a bone, and a pretty big one. And then you've got to come out of the gate storming. No swaps, no nothing. 40% done by 10:15. By 11 o'clock, all your trades have to be gone, because by lunchtime, word's gonna be out. And by 2 o'clock, you're gonna be selling at 65 cents on the dollar, if you're lucky. And then the feds are gonna be in here, up your ass, trying to slow you down.
Ramesh.
They can slow you down. They can't stop you. It's yours to sell.
But John, even if we manage to pull that off, and that's saying something. The real question is, who are we selling this to?
Same people we've been selling it to for the last 2 years, and whoever else will buy it.
But John, if you do this, You will kill the market for years. It's over. And you're selling something that you know has no value.
We are selling to willing buyers at the current fair market price, so that we may survive.
You will never sell anything to any of those people ever again.
I understand.
Do you?
Do you? This is it. I'm telling you, this is it.
City, this is Eric.
Give me Elliot.
City.
Hey, it's Will Emerson.
William, how are you?
I'm all right. How's the trouble and strife?
Busting my ass, as always.
You see, that's why I tried to tell you, John. Why do you think I'm single?
I know you did. What can I do for you?
Listen, I just got the tap on my shoulder, and we've got some risk over here that we need to move. So today, it looks like my loss is your gain.
What kind of size are you talking?
Should be on your screen. I just sent it.
Jesus, where does this land?
96 on the dollar.
91.
All three, and we're done at 94.
93 and a half.
Done.
Trading.
Hello, gorgeous.
Will, what's happening over there?
Well, today's moving day.
What are you guys so worked up about?
You think they tell me anything? All I know is that today, my loss is your gain. Now, you're a friendly, so I'll come to you first. I got 270 mil, a 15-year paying out a point and a half above par.
Where's it from?
Where's it from? Do you care?
No, not really. Now, where's the trade? Now, I'm hearing things
Alexis,
that you guys are scaring
me.
Alexis,
I'm only sharing
apart.
This with you right now. 85.
Done.
Deutsche?
It's Will Emerson.
Fuck you, you limey bastard.
Are you still angry about that?
Word's out. I'm hanging up now.
Merrill.
Lawrence.
What the fuck are you guys doing over there?
Just a little spring cleaning.
That is not what I'm hearing.
All right, Lawrence. Are you a buyer?
I'm not sure anymore. Where at?
Well, it sounds like I should be asking you where at.
What are we talking about here?
375 mil, 30-year mixed.
Fuck me.
Are you with me on this?
63 cents.
Oh, fuck you. I'm hanging up.
63.
Let me call my man here. I'll come back to you in 5.
Maybe 55 and 5.
Well, all right then. Stay on the line. Sam, pick up the phone. Sam, get on the line.
Yeah.
I got Lawrence and Merrill.
Where are we?
63 cents.
Jesus. On what?
375 mixed day.
Get him to 65 and hit it.
Are you fucking kidding me? That's... What is that? That's a $131 million loss on a single trade.
I understand. Hit it.
Hey, Lawrence, we're Phil of Killer 65.
It's filled.
Oh, come on, Sam. Put a smile on your face. You did some good today. You said that yourself. Do you know, I'm starting to feel a little better about this whole thing. You're one of the luckiest guys in the world, Sam. Could have been digging ditches all these years.
That's true. And if I had, at least there'd be some holes in the ground to show for it. I just don't know how we fucked this up quite so much.
When did you start feeling so sorry for yourself? It's unbearable. What? So you think we might have put a few people out of business today? That's all for naught. But you've been doing that every day for almost 40 years, Sam. And if this is all for naught, then so is everything out there. It's just money. It's made up. Pieces of paper with pictures on it so we don't have to kill each other just to get something to eat.